Chris Spiker for Antelope Valley Florist. I'm going to show you how we do the lilies, the large stargazer oriental lilies. And come in from the grower, stems of 10, and they come in cellophane. So this is biodegradable, it's a corn product, different than plastic, which is a petroleum product. So I'm pretty happy about that. Stems of 10, and you want the foliage to be green, no black, nothing hanging off, and typically it's got two or three flowers per stem, with one open and one, we call this cracking. You know, so if you get one of these in an arrangement, you're pretty happy because it's showing color and you know it's going to open. This guy might even open under the right circumstances, especially if you recut the stems, put them in fresh water, so pour the water out, recut the stems. Everybody needs to buy a pair of these or find a pair. Every house, yeah. After I took the seminar, I went and bought a pair because trying to do it with scissors just doesn't work. You know. These are not snips, these are scissors, these are for paper. So when they come into me, I will pull a couple stems off because the water starts from here and it's going to the flowers. This is perfect, this is cracking. This is gonna stay in the bucket because like maybe Thursday, this will be nice. But most people, when they get this in an arrangement, it's like, it was all buds. Yeah, it's gonna be, you know, a $10 flower, but right now it's just a bud. So, especially for holidays, we get our lilies in a week early. Or smart wholesalers take these and put them in water and get them open, because florists and the public want them like this, or like this. This is a good thing, you know, to have a white lily like this. When these lilies started out 40 years ago, they were rubrum lilies, and they all hung down. Really neat. But the public doesn't want a flower that hangs down. To them, that looks like it's dead. Well, that's just the way they grow. And so the botanists had to figure out how to breed it with something that, so now there are stargazers that gaze up, or these are called starfighters. And that guy made a lot of money, the one that developed how to get the lilies to face up. And it was really hard to find a bunch of lilies with bad leaves, so just pretend like this was good flowers. If these were good flowers, and I needed the flowers today, I might still buy these. But obviously, if you look in the package and you see these kind of leaves, or you feel it's real slimy, just pass on. Yeah, this, it was hard for a supplier to come up. This must have been one in his trash can or something. You know, and some people might still go, oh, that's a nice flower. But I would cut the bunch, pull the leaves off, give it a fresh cut, and give the flowers water. They ship like this so that the blossoms aren't damaged. If they're wide open like this when they're laying in a box or they're getting handled a lot, you know, there's only two or three flowers on a stem and they all have to be perfect. Someone's going to go, well, that one had a broken petal on it and now I can't use it, and I'm taking it home or something. So that's flower care. You inspect them. You know, sometimes, like some of the flowers, like delphinium, that little blue flower, or baby's breath, or daisies, if you shake them like this and things fall out, I mean, parts fall out, the flowers are done. Yeah, things fall out too, you know. But that's immigration's job, you know, see if there's bugs coming in. And they work with large white tables down at the airport. And they open up a box at random and go like this. Anything comes out, trash, doesn't come in. So that's opening the lilies. That's something with a crack. Inspecting. Cellophane wrapped. That's everything I had about lilies. And every stem is different. You can tell we go to great pains and lots of happy suppliers to make sure we get the perfect flowers. So they're going to sit in water. We got a fresh cut, they're going to sit in water. And that's that.